you about one of our really cool and creative fresh paint to go activities. And it's called Make a Castle or Make a City Out of Foam. And it's really fun and creative because there are a lot of creative elements that the kids can get into. So it's got everything here from painting the actual pieces that are really modular and get put together as you would see fit, and also developing and building them out to make this city or castle structure. So once again, there are a lot of different levels to it in terms of really getting the engagement piece for kids. So the first step would be, I would say, to paint all of the different pieces here. So we've got everything from the 3D balls to the other circular bases here to the cube, and all those pieces should be painted first. You can do a couple layers, because what I've found is that the actual foam itself tends to absorb a lot of paint. So I would suggest, you know, of course, you can start with some brushes. We also use a lot of sponges here at the studio. So those are great for sort of doing some layering and maybe adding two coats of paint so that you get some good paint coverage and the colors are nice and bright. So after you've done that, you can put your pieces aside and let them all dry up. One of the tricks we use here is using a hairdryer for drying. And that's a great way to speed it up, but you know, it's not something you need to do. Definitely you can let it all sit and then wait to do the next step. The next step would be putting it all together. So, I mean, we can definitely just use some regular glue. If we want it to be a little bit more robust, perhaps we could use hot glue. With kids, of course, we want to be careful with the hot glue. If that's a concern, I would suggest just using some regular glue. The trick here in terms of getting these balls to stay on top was sort of racking my brain, because it was a project I did with my daughter, and we were thinking about, well, how can we get these balls to stay on top without them falling off with just using regular glue? So what we came up with was to use toothpicks, and it's pretty cool. You can use the toothpick and then they actually get stuck into the actual shape and then get stuck into the other shape so that they can be very sturdy and they don't fall off. If you're just trying to put a few of the small ones in place, you can use glue if you want, but we did use some toothpicks here as well on this platform to get the smaller ones to stay. You just want to be mindful, of course, the toothpicks are a little sharp so that you don't get the top end to poke out there. If you're concerned about using toothpicks, you can also use wooden dowels that are really sort of thin, and you can get those from most craft stores and you can use those as a substitute as well. So that would be the steps in terms of how to put it all together. What I would also suggest is, if you want to really build it out, you can build it into a whole little environment, or the castle could be a whole structure with other pieces around it. So it's a whole environment in and of itself. You could paint your platform. So here we've got a wooden platform that we're using. You could actually use cardboard too, if that's something that you'd like to use as an option. The platform will really just be there to help you add other environmental elements to this structure. So you've got everything from, you know, car that you can add. We've got these little wooden shapes, we've got a bird. What else do we have here? We have a house. So these elements could be glued into your platform on the bottom after it's painted to really, again, sort of develop the project. One other thing that we could use for the project would be these really fun little cubes. They come in different colors, and you can sort of build up everything from bridge. You could do some kind of an archway or different sort of elements into your city or castle structure there. So that's something else that could also be added to this project, just to make it, again, have different levels of creativity. So I found that this is a really fun one in terms of keeping the kids creative and engaged. And it's one that has a lot of different creative elements to it. So if you don't happen to have these elements at home, or you're having difficulty finding them, we actually do have a Fresh Paint to Go kit that's available. It can be delivered to you, or we can arrange for a door pickup as well. So that's something that we offer in addition to just providing you with some crafty ideas for the kids. If you would like more information about our kits, you can check out our website, freshpaintstudio.ca. Or you can just send us an email at info@freshpaintstudio.ca. So thanks so much for watching. I hope this was interesting and informative, and you found it to be something that the kids can use to keep themselves busy. Thanks again, and take care.